Hello friends, so in this video I'm going to give you a course review on a mechanical engineering course. So this video is going to be about advanced mechanics of solid. So sometime before I had put video about the course review about mechanics of solid, and there I had enforced upon truss. Now we are going to go a little bit higher and we are going to understand about buckling. So in a life, you should not buckle up on your decisions. So that's what I want to mean over here. And this is the process of bending of a cantilever beam. So let's start with the process. So in the video, I'm going to give you some major topics which are studied in this course, some of the study resources, and what is the evaluation scheme, and the fields of application of this course, and some of the related courses to the current course, which is Advanced Mechanics of Solid. So Advanced Mechanics of Solid is usually abbreviated as AMOS or AMOS. And for this, obviously the prerequisite is understanding and having a clarity of MOS, which is Mechanics of Solid. So if you have not seen the video about the review of Mechanics of Solid, you should first pause this and go back to get and understand everything about Mechanics of Solid and then come back to this one. And so let's continue. The Advanced Mechanics of Solid is more towards design engineering and less towards manufacturing. Though the Mechanics of Solid had some part of manufacturing too with it. And if you have not seen where the design engineering would lie or where Advanced Mechanics of Solid lie in the complete branching of mechanical engineering, you should check the domain video where I have explained the three major domains of mechanical engineering, and check how advanced mechanical engineering parts of advanced mechanics of solid lie and how are they related with other subjects. And this is also a completely numerical based course where obviously the theory is there, but you are expected to solve numericals. And obviously the exams and questions will be completely based on numericals. You won't be asked any theory questions in exam. And if we go on making more advanced questions from the numericals asked in the exam, you will find those questions are based on practical situations. So if something interests you, this would definitely interest you. That is one thing. And I would say, from my personal experience of studying this course, I found Advanced Mechanics of Solid a bit relatively tougher than Mechanics of Solid, because over here we have complex calculations which will come generally, and we may get lose the track, the path, and lose the focus and make calculation mistakes. That's the one major thing. And another, the equations involved, the concepts involved are relatively tough to remember to. And the major topics are very much similar to Mechanics of Solid, but everywhere we are going one step higher to what we had studied on Mechanics of Solid. So again, we'll study about stress and strain, stress strain temperature relations, where the effect of temperature like heating or cooling, and what the effect is on stress and strain inside a solid. Then we'll understand material characterization, where we can find out is it is a orthotropic material, symmetric matrix, non-symmetric matrix, etc. So this is very interesting. You will learn a lot about matrices also, and learn how materials can be characterized and what kind of material properties change with different type of changes in the matrice of the or the matrix of the material. Then we'll understand the energy method, which is used to solve problems and find out stress, strain, or deformations. So this is one of the methods. The another method is the classical method, where we solve equations of force or momentum. Over here, we'll solve the equations of energy. Again, we'll understand the bending, torsion, and buckling thing. Okay. Which is similar to what we had in Mechanics of Solid. Next, some of the resources which I used were the lectures, because textbook was not at all useful to understand all the tough concepts where we need to understand things and details of the figures drawn in the textbook. So over there, we need definitely need a professor who can explain things clearly. Then textbook is obviously useful to have reference of what different kind of questions can come, and we can practice some of those questions. So we have better hands and head start for the exam. Then definitely previous year questions will be helpful because there are a lot of different varieties of question possible in this, and professors tend to use same kind of questions year on year. So on that front, previous year questions can be useful to get a perspective of what kind of question can come up on your question paper. Then for professor, so we had Professor Inyan, and he was an excellent professor, though he started his teaching career recently after since 1 or 2 years, but still he is excellent while teaching. If you have any queries, he will be happy to help, and if you have the same queries multiple times, he will come up with some new way, new perspective to teach you the same concept. So still, if you are not convinced of what he's explaining, keep on asking the same question and he will try his best to explain you. And for evaluation, so he may give you some quiz, he may give you some surprise quiz, and usually the professor is good enough to solve some of the questions of textbook during the class, so you have better clarity of what a numerical solving is actually. These numericals are going to be very lengthy, and you should have complete clarity of using formulas and being consistent with the units also. And in fields, so as I said earlier, this is a field where designing is involved, and all the formulas which are there, all the concepts which are developed are used for designing and in softwares. So if you got interested in studying this, you would have definitely got interested in design of machine elements, CAD and manufacturing process. And if you are to choose some disciplinary electives of the department, you can choose fracture mechanics and mechanical equipment design as your DELs. So if you have any queries, do comment, and the course handout will be available in the description. Okay, so thank you.